I think the whole shopping experience is transformed into half digital and half physical, because there's a part of the fun cannot be replaced by sitting in front of a computer or keyboards to do online shopping.
I think one of the really interesting things that you were mentioning about, you know, people taking their devices when they go shopping and they're interacting with their devices while they're also interacting with the physical store. And so we've got this strange thing happening now where online, offline is completely seamless, but not just from the customer's point of view, but also from the retailer's point of view, because the shop assistant, when you're coming in through the door, that shop assistant knows everything about you, because the shop assistant's device has picked you up, has told the shop assistant, this person coming through the door likes this type of jeans, has bought this before, has done this before, and also likes going to the theater. And so before you even walk in the door, you've got a personalized level of service, which is really fascinating.
Yes, not only that, but also the actual store does not need the extra size for storage, because you have your display and the items, the goods in the front of house, but then your back of house is massively cut by not necessary holding all the stocks in the stores. They can have a much bigger shop, more comfortable shopping environment for customers to look around. And the logistic also cut down a lot, because they are more centralized, processed in one place, rather than if I've got 100 shops in 10 different cities. Imagine that every day the trucks and lorries moving, restocking, then you save a lot of manpower.
It also helps, of course, because if that balance works well, at the moment, online fashion retailing, for instance, has a massive problem about returns due to lack of fit. Whereas if the offline store actually has one of every size, you go along and you try it, logistics improves, that it gets delivered straight to your home, and the online returns, which of course are loss-making, then they disappear, because you're actually going, it's a fascinating idea. But how about the stores themselves? Because what we're reading about is a lot of stores going into bankruptcy, especially the big national retailers that had many, many shops in all the towns and cities throughout Europe. What is the reason for that? Is it that they can't match to the new online, or is it just simply they had too many stores?
Both reasons are correct. Because some big chain, they just over-expanded a bit in the last 5 years everywhere globally. And then some cities, failed to do as good as the other places. Because traditionally, especially in Europe, they will have the shops open in a remote area, in a big shopping center or outlet places. But in Asia, I think, especially China, they just go directly to online and make it very successful. And then on the other hand, they are developing all the city centers, and with a better planning ahead, they are really able to make a 24/7 for activities. And it's not just like a dead finance business area where weekend or evenings, they're quiet, not well used, the lands. And because of the shopping malls supporting the residential and then the office users. And so it makes it very vibrant. So the shopping malls in China, they tend to move themselves towards a very good mix of positioning, like adding arts and culture elements in it.
So the shopping mall, in a sense, ceases to be a shopping mall and becomes more of
a town center. It's a forum.
Exactly.